Why do we need space? Because you keep saying that. Why do we need space?
Because neither one of us, because I'm not going to lie, you write about me, I don't have boundaries. But you don't either.
I do have boundaries.
Hey, I don't want you here right now. Can you go in there and close the door? You legally ain't supposed to be here.
And you legally, you unopened the door, you let me in here, and now you want to sit there and use that against me
because you're right, Jeannie. I don't want to leave you outside. Vera's one thing, I ain't married to her, but you, no, I don't want to leave you outside. So I kind of to my heart because you're right. Let me not say kind of to my heart. Period, because you're right. I need to provide for you, even with a legal separation and restraining order. I'm like, you know what?
Abe, I don't even know why you're wearing that in a restraining order. Mm, okay, you said that you was going to do that.
Please, and I don't want to do it to you. Please. You said I can't leave you outside? I didn't. Please give me my space.
Please. Why do you need space every time I want to talk to you?
This is why somebody has to move right now.
Because I'm asking you questions on being a wife?
I don't.
Because I'm flat out trying to talk to you just like you talked to me last night. And then you went outside and freaking left this morning after you slept in the bed and went without a restraining order.
I'm sure you're recording me.
Stop playing. But you're the one that has all the legal rights to record people, so whatever.
Go ahead. Let's talk.
Why do we need space?
Jeannie, because...
what am I doing to you? I'm not doing nothing. All I asked you was to do what you're supposed to do. As a husband, we'll just take care of this house and stop giving money to organizations that we can't afford. So where or not do we need space? That's all I asked you. And that's what she heard yesterday. And you had a whole conversation with me. And it was fine. Then you told her to come back here.
If you don't need space away from me, because you probably don't, Jamie, I need space away from you because everything I need to do to get better involves...
Everything you need to do to get better involves therapy. And we had talked about that a long time ago, that you could have took your behind somewhere because you're a veteran. You don't have to sit, you didn't have to even sit here and deal what you did today if this is about you getting help. You don't have to run off with all of the money, leave me outside homeless to be better. You can go check yourself in somewhere and do that for free because you're not going to need any money in there. So why you keep sitting here trying to confuse me and say it's because you need treatment, because it's not about treatment, because you could just go to treatment.
Okay, fine. You need to get yourself together too.
No, I don't need to get myself together. You're the one that told me to stop working. You're the one that did all this and said, oh, Jeannie, this is for us. So I can sit down because I'm aware that your back is messed up. I'm aware that I keep on being the reason why you're not working. I told you you could sit down. And then because you don't want to hear my mouth, you make drastic actions and sit there and go put restraining orders and put my name in legal paperwork. After everything that you've done to me legally, I am not sit there and just went up there and lie on you to go get some paperwork to be vindictive. Because if you need treatment, you need to be a man for me. Go to treatment, Abe. Stop trying to mess up my life for you to go to treatment. Which is why I don't believe nothing that's coming out your mouth right now. Because if it's about treatment, today was not necessary. You could have said, babe, I need to go to treatment. I need to be away from you. I need to go to treatment and not sit up here and get everything you did.
I need to be away from you and not be in no institution.
Why do you think that you don't need to be an institution, and what does that have to do with being institutionalized? Because everything's not an institution. You can go check yourself into a center. I'm not talking about like your
that's
mom.
That's an institution, and then I'll
and that's right what away. That's what you need, and that don't mean you have to sign your rights away for the rest of your life because treatment is for you to get treatment and get out.
No. Once I'm in that system, they can keep me for life. They'll just keep me.
And you're sitting up here, not even taking your meds.
Yes, I am. You're alive.
And if you just told me 2 days ago.
I was 2 days behind, like 4 days ago. I'm caught up now. Hey, even that. Anyway, so that's my answer, Jeannie. I'm not going to be institutionalized.
So you're not going to do what's best for this marriage. Well, how are you putting me all out when you're the one that needs treatment? What's best for this marriage, Abe? If you need treatment, then you need to go to a place. They cannot keep you there forever.
So you asked me, I So if you don't like what I'm saying, you don't agree with me. That's fine. But that's what it is, so. Anything else you want to talk about?
So you're going to keep letting some crap from your mom mess up the marriage? Yes, it is. Because why don't you want to go?
I messed up for 5 years, Jeannie.
What do you mean you messed up for 5 years?
You love telling me that, right? Because this is another reason we can't cohabitate. Let me start using technical terms.
Why we can't cohabitate? Why? Because you want me to sit here and act like the past didn't happen and like you have actually been doing right by me for 5 years when you haven't?
I'm not going to get better if you keep doing that and you can't help yourself. I realize it.
And if you go to a program, I will be able to not be talking to you about it because you will go be actually getting the help that you told me when you got married that you was going to go get. I feel like you just in a space because you think that because what happened to your mom. Anybody trying to lock you off forever. If you need treatment to go in somewhere, go in somewhere. We even talked about this before today, but your strategy of it is just take me down with you, and I don't understand it. Like, I'm not the one that's sitting up here.
You look very loud. You're not even supposed to be here. No, I'm done.
God, you won't even, it's like, you won't even talk to me.
You leave me supposed to be here and everybody knows because the cops being
right. And the whole, all the neighbors just see me came back in here.
Okay, Jeannie, whatever. I don't want to have this conversation with you. However, you're not wrong in saying we talk. So, the solution is we need a mediator. You want for free from saying you can't. Because you're right. Can't keep not talking to each other. So, I swear to you, on this wire, I'm not BSing you. If we could communicate,
it's just crazy to me, Andy, because when you was with Aaron, you swear up and down, you left and you went to Arizona, which you don't even have to do that here. You went to Arizona because you need to be better. You wanted her to wait.
It wasn't an institution,
but you was trying to do what you needed to do for your marriage. You don't care about me at all because you're sitting here putting me through this when you could just go somewhere. Which I guess has something to do with your trust of me.
Correct.
Why do you not trust me? Why do you think I'm trying to have you locked up when my whole thing has been, hey, do everything up until that point, but you haven't done that?
very good. It's very good. I was very impressed. And it's neat because it almost functions like an app without having to actually be an app. So whether you're using a smartphone or a desktop, it works. I was very impressed. Yeah. Intake to started where I can start, and that's, you know, directly with the government. So I'm waiting. So we, as a church, our 501c3 church has already submitted. I say paperwork, but it's online. Everything's online these days. Submitted to, it's called SAM, System for Awards Management. I'm saying it right, because that's step one. In order to do any business with the government, you have to be registered. And they are slow with everything, so they've already verified our 501c3 status, and now they're, I don't know what they're doing now, it just says in process. Yeah, so so once all that's done, then the next step, if I understand correctly, because this is my own kind of popping together research, the program that is most appropriate for faith-based organizations such as ours would be Supportive Services for Veteran Families, SSVF. And that is the program that I used, my wife and I used it to get out of homelessness, in addition to, you know, me getting disability as well. So it took a lot of things to get me out. Yeah, coordination, exactly. So so I know from personal experience that that program works, and the problem I found is the lack of coordination, especially for folks like us out here in East County, because all to get any help, we have to go to San Diego, we have to go to La Jolla, you know, it's insane. And so when if we can actually get approved for these grant funds, I mean, that can do everything from providing a van for transportation to and from programs, or to and from appointments, to another thing I'm trying to do, they have what's called veteran service organizations, such as VBSD, such as DAVE, or DAV, so VCS, Veteran Community Services. Those are all veteran service organizations. So I'm not necessarily that ambitious, but anybody that goes through the proper training can be certified as a veteran service representative, and they can actually help veterans with their disability claims, because again, without that disability money, I wouldn't be here right now. Yeah, it just, me even working full time, it was never enough money. So so yeah, what I see happening here in El Cajon, what I like to see at least, is, like I said, that coordinated effort where it has transportation to those veterans, where it has case management, because it's not one size fits all. Every veteran is going to have a different set of needs, different set of strengths. You know, you can't only care to families, you can't only care to singles, you can't only care to women, because you're going to miss so many people. So, so yeah, coordinated strategy that includes the housing, that includes the referrals, transportation, and of course the spiritual component, where, you know, whether they're Christian, Muslim, Buddhist, atheist, whatever it is, some type of offering so that part of their lives is met as well. So just a holistic approach, which has always been my ministry philosophy ever since seminary. That's what I see happening. No, we were meeting at the library before COVID-19. So now everything's kind of up in the air.